Stations of the Cross. Let us briefly enter with Jesus on the journey he makes through Jerusalem, from the fortress of Pilate near the temple to outside the walls, to the hill of Calvary and a tomb nearby. There is a sense of dread we feel today. A mighty storm seems to approach. The world, it seems, holds its breath to see what is about to happen. Let us pray. As these events unfold before us today, loving Father, help us to be witnesses of your love. Help us to not be merely bystanders, onlookers, simply watching and waiting. By the power of our baptism, in which your Holy Spirit first stirred in our hearts, now stir up our hearts once again to recognize the immense love with which you have made us, and the profound love with which you have redeemed us in Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who walks this way of the cross in our place. Help us to find the meaning of our life's journey in his journey. Make our hearts overflow with gratitude that this journey of Jesus brings with it the possibility of a new heaven and a new earth, and help us to offer ourselves with Jesus on the cross to make his mission our mission. We unite our hearts today with the offering of Jesus, your Son, so that living the faith of the journey of the cross, we might also live with the hope of life eternal in his resurrection on the last day. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The first station. Jesus is condemned to die. On the Jewish feast of the Passover, it was the custom for the Roman prefect, Pontius Pilate, to give freedom to one prisoner chosen by the people. Pilate wants to release Jesus because he could not find him guilty of any crime. But Pilate gives in to the demands of the crowd. He frees a murderer named Barabbas instead and hands Jesus over to be scourged and crucified. Dear Jesus, it isn't right. You did nothing wrong. You are the Son of God, and you became a man to bring your Father's justice and mercy into the world. Because without you, we could not hope for heaven. You came to teach us to love you and to love one another as you love us. Help me always to love you more. Help me to learn how to not judge others. Teach me to be understanding and forgiving with the people in my life. Show me how to see with your eyes, Jesus. The second station. Jesus takes up his cross. After severely whipping and beating Jesus, soldiers dress him in a royal purple robe and place a crown of sharp thorns on his head. They humiliate him, shouting, "Hail, King of the Jews!" He is given an impossibly heavy wooden cross to carry to Calvary, the place where he will be crucified. Dear Jesus, I am afraid when my problems seem too heavy for me. Give me the grace I need to do the hard things I must do, and the wisdom to turn to you when I need help. I know you are always here to help me, especially in difficult times. Teach me to be kind, because now I can see how much you suffer when I hurt other people or disrespect them. The third station. Jesus falls the first time. Jesus is already weak from being cruelly whipped. He falls under the weight of the cross. But his determination to do his Father's will is stronger than his physical suffering, and he struggles back to his feet and goes forward. Dear Jesus, it is because we fall into sin and selfishness that you now fall beneath the weight of our cross for us. Teach us to be strong like you. When we are tempted, keep our consciences true and help us to remember that you are there to keep us from falling. Lift me up, Jesus, so that you and I can continue to walk together always. The fourth station. Jesus meets his mother, Mary. Jesus sees Mary, his mother, in the crowd at the side of the road. Their meeting is short, only a pause, and Mary is crying silently. The disciples tried to keep Mary at home today, to avoid the anger and false judgments of the crowd. Mary insists on being there and to see for herself how much her son loves his people, the son who was given to her by the Father and the Holy Spirit. Dear Jesus, you gave us your mother Mary to be our mother too, to comfort us and be with us. As I follow you today and always, I know the way will be hard. Help me turn to her and to ask her for her special help. Also, help me to never hurt my own mother and father, because they love and care for me and suffer with me as Mary did for you on the way to Calvary. The fifth station. Simon helps Jesus carry the cross. The soldiers did not want Jesus to die before he gets to Calvary, but he is very weak from the scourging that he has received from them. They grab an onlooker from the crowd, Simon of Cyrene, to help Jesus carry the heavy cross. Dear Jesus, I wish now that the soldiers had chosen me to help you. You are so good and gentle, and if everyone had taken just a little bit of that weight of the cross, your burden would have been lighter. Help me to know the ways in which I can help you, even if it's just a small part of your work today. Help me to be generous in my neighborhood and in my church, and to grow up knowing that you call us to help you save souls. The sixth station. Veronica wipes the face of Jesus. As Jesus struggles along the way of the cross, he continues to bleed from the crown of thorns and the wounds he has received. He is covered with sweat, and blood is getting in his eyes. A woman in the crowd, Veronica, is overcome with compassion. She runs to Jesus, and taking her veil, she wipes his face. Dear Jesus, I want to do what is right and good, but sometimes I am afraid what others might say. Help me to be brave like Veronica, to act without fear in saying and doing the right thing. Help me to stand firm in my faith and my desire to love you more each day, even when others have turned their backs on you. The seventh station. Jesus falls a second time. Jesus' legs are wearing out with each new step. He falls again. The weight of the cross forces him to the ground, but he gets up again, a second time, and keeps going. Dear Jesus, it is my sin that continues to be so heavy that you fall again. Yet, I sin again and again. Like your way to Calvary, in my confessing, you give me your forgiveness again and again. You give me your hand, and I have the strength to get up and start over. Thank you for never giving up on me. Help me to never sin against you again, and grant that I may love you always. The eighth station. Jesus speaks to the women of Jerusalem. Jesus then sees a group of women weeping and crying about how badly he has been treated. They are terrified by the brutal violence of this scene. He says to them, "Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me, but weep for yourselves and for your children." Dear Jesus, even as you suffer, you teach us to seek your truth and not miss the point of what is happening here. Help me to be more concerned with others instead of always worrying about myself. Gather together our community in active worship of God and the life of the sacraments. Don't let us pass up the opportunity of the new life you offer us. The ninth station. Jesus falls a third time. Jesus, after having gone about as far as he can, falls again under the cross. Clearly, he is near dying, but again, he slowly gets up and continues the way of the cross. Dear Jesus, your failing strength makes me see how helpless I am. Help me to rely on your strength, to see how much I need you. Give me the faith I need to remember that you always walk with me, that you will never leave me. In moments of suffering or hardship, help me always to see the value in making it an offering to you, as you have done for me. The 10th Station. Jesus is stripped of his clothes. Jesus finally comes to the place where he will be crucified. The soldiers tear away his clothes from his wounded body, and Jesus, humiliated, stands now before the crowd with no possessions at all. The soldiers take his clothes and divide them up among themselves. Lord Jesus, seeing you so cruelly treated makes me think about how sometimes my own possessions are way too important to me. I am too concerned with my own accomplishments. I have to have my way too often. Teach me to share the things I have with people in need. Teach me to seek the things in this life that are really important and pleasing to you and beneficial to me and others. Help me to let go of those things in my life that distract me and prevent me from growing closer to you and to others. The 11th Station. Jesus is nailed to the cross. The soldiers lay Jesus down on the cross and drive heavy nails through his hands and his feet so that he can no longer move. They move the cross to a hole in the ground and set it upright, and Jesus hangs on the cross that he has carried, crucified between two thieves. Even now, Jesus forgives the soldiers and the people who were making fun of him and shouting at him, and he prays to his Father, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." Dear Jesus, the pain you felt on the cross was for me. Now, when I hear people laugh at you or use your name in anger, give me the strength to stand up for you and tell them of your great love for them. When I feel angry or hurt because of something wrong done to me, teach me not to hold a grudge. Help me to see your example and pray for the strength to forgive that person. The 12th Station. Jesus dies on the cross. After several hours of agony, Jesus cries out in a loud voice, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." He gives his mother, Mary, to his beloved disciple, St. John, who is also there, standing at the foot of the cross. Finally, he breathes his last breath, and darkness comes over the earth. The great curtain made of iron in the Holy of Holies in the temple is torn in two, top to bottom. We are no longer separated from the temple of Jesus' body, which he will rebuild in 3 days. Look upon me, good and gentle Jesus, while I kneel here. Make my soul strong in faith, hope, and love. Make me really sorry for my sins, that I may never sin again. As I think upon your 5 wounds with deep sorrow and compassion, I recall, good Jesus, the words you gave your prophet David. They have pierced my hands and my feet. I can count all my bones. I love you, Jesus. I am sorry for ever offending you. Grant that I may love you always. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. The 13th Station. Jesus' body is taken down from the cross. The crowds have all gone home. Joseph of Arimathea, a follower and friend of Jesus, goes to Pilate and asks for Jesus' body. With tenderness, he goes to Calvary and carefully takes the lifeless, damaged body of Jesus down from the cross and prepares it for burial. Dear Jesus, fill the sadness of our hearts with faith and hope in the life that is yet to come. Keep your everlasting love always before us and guide us on the road that leads to you in your heavenly kingdom. Help us to place our lives in your gentle hands. The 14th station. Jesus' body is laid in the tomb. Jesus' body is placed in a tomb which has been carved out of rock. A large stone is rolled across the entrance, and everyone hurries home, for the sun is setting and the Sabbath has begun. Dear Jesus, by your 3 days in the tomb, you have made holy the graves of all those who have died in the hope of rising again. You were laid to rest in the darkness of the tomb, that we might rise to eternal life, a place of light and peace. Help us never to fear death. Help us always to remember your promise of life, even in the darkest times. You have died for us. Lord Jesus, Son of the living God, have mercy on us. Teach us to recognize your presence with us always, especially in the Eucharist, when the memorial of this great mystery of the cross is made present to us. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, You sent down Your abundant blessing upon Your people, who have devoutly recalled the death of Your Son in the sure hope of the resurrection. Grant them pardon. Bring them comfort. May their faith grow stronger and their salvation be assured. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us go in peace.